Hi guys, this is Paridhi Tripathi again, and today we are in conversation with, oh my god, where do I begin from? She's called the Nightingale, she's called the Queen Bee, she's called the Queen of Melody. She's the first Indian singer to have her wax statue in London. She is awarded the highest honor in London by the House of Commons of the UK. There is a day declared by her name by the government of governor of US, Ohio. The Shreya Ghoshal Day, which happens to be on 26th June.
Yeah, I
guess. Yeah? Of course, we are in conversation with the Shreya Ghoshal. Welcome to Zen Speak, Shreya.
Thank you so much, and it's a pleasure to be here, Paridhi. Thank you.
First of all, congratulations on your just-released album, Dhadkane Azaad Hain. It's a lovely song. How did the whole idea of having your own first single came?
That idea actually came also. The song was something that was with me for many years, and I have some such unreleased songs of mine and compositions which are half-made, and I think that it was about 7-8 years ago that we started working on an album, but we never even went on to finishing the songs, and never happened. So finally I felt the need at this time that, of having been doing film songs for so many years, I wanted to do something which came from naturally from nowhere and it's not connected to films. Because every time a film song dictates the kind of song it has to be, the how I'm going to be singing, because it all depends on the character's situation, whether she is a matured person or a very young girl, so uske hisab se I have to perform. So sometimes I feel that those boundaries are too restricting, so I thought, let's start with a single. This is a new thing I started, and I just loved doing this, and the process of doing something completely on your own without anyone saying what to do. Just doing everything, in the sense I was producing the whole thing from the music bit to the video, being able to get this whole process done and finished, and the excitement from the fans, just knowing that I'm doing completely a new kind of a thing, is very encouraging. And I just love the response that the day I actually announced Dhadkane Azaad Hain, there was a hashtag Dhadkane Azaad Hain, and it was trending all over Twitter for days. So I feel it's a right time to do it. And today I feel, thanks to all the wonderful fans out there and their absolute unconditional love for my life, for my music, I just want to give them something from me without any, it's unadulterated, it's completely unfiltered, it's just for them, without any via media, through this, through that, it's just straight to the fans.
Of course, I think we are all in love with that, we're all in love with you, for that matter. Your journey began at a very early age, but what took you so long to finally release your first album? I think
This is the first single. I have done an album in 2013, but it was a very niche album. It was all ghazals. It was that time I had a feeling that why am I not doing... Actually, in this whole platform that I'm trying to establish for myself, and I hope that other artists also do as much, is the kind of music that we are not able to do it in films. Films mein bahut, as I said, of course the story and other things are commercial. Every song has to be a nightclub hit. That is the way the music is made today. Every producer, every music label has a say in what the song should be like. So that can be sometimes very frustrating creatively, not just for me as a singer, but for the composers, lyricists, and everyone who is part of making music for nothing else but music. So this is that relaxing phase of so I will be balancing these two, do work for films and then take out time for doing this also. So 13 mein maine Hamnashi jo album ki thi wo bahut hi purely classical genre ke ghazals ka tha, to wahan pe maine puri apni bhadas nikali thi, like things that I can't do in films I did completely as an album. There were almost 7-8 songs. This one I did not do as an album because I thought album needs a lot many more songs, and sometimes not all the songs get the due love and attention. So hence the first attempt at single. And the next single is also ready and it'll be coming very soon. Wow, so yeah. So this was a twin project actually. So these two songs were planned together, and ek ek karke I'm just gonna be releasing them.
Wow, that's a lovely surprise, I must say. You've also featured in the video. How was the experience?
Good fun. Actually, this video was planned very, very in this room right here with my director Parashar. We were like, ye dono gaane suno, ab bolo kya karna chahiye. I seen that one song, the other one is a little more somber song, and it needed a. And in my head, when I listen to a song, I have mental pictures of images. I mean, it does that to anyone. If you have not seen the film or the visuals already, but any song can give you a sense of visuals. So I felt that that other one needed snow. It needed bluish film, or the color should be like that. It is a slightly more sad song. Whereas Dhadkane is full blast, you know, happiness. It just gives you a sense of openness, and it's a happy spirit song. And romantic also. So we had to shoot this in one go, back to back, 2 days, one location, and we should be able to do this. Because of course I'm doing it on my own. I need to take out that much time, energy, and be focused, and we'll finish this and I'll move on. And I tell you, it was an experience in itself. It's a story. I can write a book on that. How to not be a producer, and if you turn into one, how to do disaster management. So, well, we were about to take our flight to Manali. Of course, Manali jaane ke liye pehle pahuncho, phir bahut lambi road journey hai. And this was in the end of the winters. So by then, snow is supposed to subside, but that day, the day we were supposed to go, it started snowing so badly that the flights got cancelled. There were people who were stranded there, some of my crew who had already gone. I had to reschedule everything, and in fact my birthday, 12th of March, was supposed to be for me and celebrations. I had to cancel everything. So on the 12th of March we finally saw ki acha ye ek din bacha hai, let's go and shoot this. And with all the heavy snowfall, Manali had turned into this paradise. So when we reached there, it was, in fact, anyone who has seen the video will not know that it's actually Himachal Pradesh, it's Manali. People have asked me, which part of Europe did you show this? We like spent crores and crores of money and we shot it. Like, seriously, this is Himachal, this is our country. You have to see how beautiful our locations are. It's just, you have to just make that effort of getting there. It can be a little difficult, and have to manage a lot of things, but Himachali jo log bhi hai na, wo itne cute hai, itne helpful hai, locals. We had a very, very good time shooting these two videos.
So I guess it was all worth it, the snowstorm and everything.
Yes, it was actually blessing in disguise, and that's why Dhadkane looks like the way it is looking. You can see a whole valley of snow and not a single person, because tourism was blocked for those valleys. And since we had special permit, we could go there, and it has turned out like a dream.
Of course. Talking about music, Shreya, music has evolved over the years, it changes every year. जो गाने पिछले साल, जिस टाइप के गाने हमें पिछले साल पसंद थे, इस साल सिनेरियो डिफरेंट है. How do you look at that?
I think सब कुछ चेंज हो रहा है, पर एक चीज कॉमन रह जाती है, मेलोडी. हमारे इंडियन ऑडियंस को जिस तरह का गाना पसंद है, वी कैन नॉट रियली रियली अंडरस्टैंड और relate to a very Western kind of a tune. We don't feel it within. All said and done, however jeans pehna hai, shirt pehni hai, you know, we eat pizza, we eat pasta, we may like all that, but when it comes to music, music is roots. So if it does not touch your heart, it cannot. And it is as simple as that. Even if you have, like, when, like, I travel a lot and I'm all the time eating hotel food, like when you're going somewhere, people don't have Indian cuisine everywhere, so I'm eating all that. After a week, it's just dal chawal that I need. You need dal chawal, you know?
Of course, I guess
that's that you cannot take away from an Indian. So that's exactly the reason why I feel that sab kuch change ho jaye, sound change ho jaye, the way you're designing the song, but the melody has to stay intact as an Indian. If there is no Indian flavor to the song, to the tune, it will not touch the audience. So that is my observation of over the years. When I entered the industry 5 years ago, today, yesterday, tomorrow, jo bhi ho, gana wohi chal, logon ko pasand aata hai jahan pe genuine ek pukar hai, ek soul, soulfulness hai, ek thoda amount of Indian flavor hai. क्योंकि हमारे हमारी बोली हिंदी में हम गाने बना रहे हैं या तमिल में, जो भी हम बना रहे हैं, वो मैच ही नहीं करता अगर कुछ और हमने कर दिया उसके साथ तो. सो दैट्स द ओनली थिंग, द कॉन्स्टेंट इज मेलोडी.
ऑफ कोर्स आई थिंक आई डू एग्री टू दैट. आई डोंट हैव टू गिव इट अ थॉट. देन कमिंग टू योर जर्नी, यू हैव संग अ लॉट ऑफ सॉन्ग्स, व्हिच वन इज योर फेवरेट?
My favorite is difficult to pick. In fact, this is what happens to me when I am making set list for my concerts. And sometimes I do feel that, अच्छा ये गाने नहीं करते, कुछ और इस बार करेंगे. फिर I cancel one of my songs from the set list. I said, ये नहीं गाऊंगी. I love that song. And करते करते it becomes a chaotic process. And my musicians also do not help me. They say, अरे आप ये नहीं गाओगे. And when I reach the stage and the audiences say that, That song, you're not singing that song. Okay. So you can't pick a song from your set list or your songs that have come. And I do believe that each of these songs have given me, it has taken me somewhere. It's a part of the whole journey. So, but I would say that, of course, my first film, Devdas, stays as sentimentally the most valuable film, the process, the nostalgia, everything. So Beri Pia, Devda, Silsila, Ye Chahat Ka, ye sab bahut, mujhe hamesha gana bachta hai na, to mujhe bilkul, it takes me back 15 years ago.
Now that you mentioned Devdas, what is, you have worked with Sanjay Leela Bhansali, and of course I remember you judging a show with him. So what is the equation with him? Because he gave you your first break, he gave you your first movie, and then you're judging a show with him, you're co-judging it.
Oh, it was very, you know, the moment, and in fact Sanjay ji ki bhi ek shart thi to the makers of that, ki agar Shreya hai to main karunga. So I think there's a sense of love and mutual, I mean, I look at him as my mentor, and the sense of respect is of a different order altogether. But that apart, there is a mutual respect for the art, you know. We have worked together, and there's a some commonality of sensibilities, the kind of music we love, the kind of he is a musician of, I believe he's actually a musician. He is a musician and director, and from songs he visualizes his stories, his characters, and so everything that he does is like music, you know. So I've learned a lot from him. So having judged, being on the panel, of course there was a lot of comfort, because I know him for so many years. And also at the same time, I used to be very conscious of the fact that any point if someone is asking me to sing, मुझे बहुत डर लगता था कि अभी संजय जी सुनेंगे बोले कि इसने ये ठीक नहीं गाया, because it happens to me. With only these few people, I really feel that I should be doing the right thing. I should not be disappointing him. I mean, I should not put him in the same way. But like my mom, dad, उनके सामने गाने में मुझे बहुत डर लगता है, क्योंकि कुछ भी गलत, मम्मी तो मेरी टीचर हैं, पापा को भी म्यूजिक बहुत depth mein pata hai, and they both have taught me music, the way how to listen to a song, you know, how to take the nuances of a song in a certain way. सो मुझे डर लगता है वैसे ही संजय जी के सामने गाने मुझे डर लगता है
But the relation, the bond you guys share, it's a lovely one, I must admit. जब making देखी थी मैंने Pinga song, हाँ, so it was.
In the studio while we are jamming, there are moments like there's a lot of fun. And Sanjay ji ke saath ek wo pura tag laga hua hai that he is, you know, he is very scary to work with. It's absolutely not true. When he is in his zone, then he will crack jokes, he will laugh, and he loves comedy. That's why I guess I feel that the whole combination of Sanjay ji and Ranveer Singh is perfect, because he loves such behavior all the time. He likes people who are, you know, very free, do not have inhibitions, and are true or honest people, and they genuinely love to laugh. So there's a weird chemistry between all the people who work with Sanjay ji. Like, sab alag alag tarike ke log hain, par ek common cheez hai, passion. Sabko apne art pe bahut bahut dedication hai and bahut passionate hai.
Sabse challenging song aapke liye kaun sa raha hai?
एक्चुअली चैलेंजिंग सॉन्ग्स रहे हैं. जब भी मैं रीजनल वर्क करती हूँ तब थोड़ा मुझे चैलेंज हो जाता है, आई गेस, व्हेन आई एम सिंगिंग इन मलयालम एंड टफ लैंग्वेजेस. व्हेन आई गेट देयर हैव बीन टाइम्स आई हैव बीन स्टक, बट दैट अपार्ट आई थिंक चैलेंजिंग सॉन्ग्स आर ऑलवेज Of having done all kinds of songs, I would not say Meri Dholna is a challenging song. I would say a simple song like, how do I say, which a very simple song is probably the most challenging song to sing, because in a simple tune you have to emote, and how to shine through and create a sense of emotion without modulating much through your voice. It's a very seedha simple song. वो बहुत मुश्किल होता है फिर. तो अभी मैं पिन पॉइंट नहीं कर पा रही हूँ, बट ऐसे हुआ है मेरे साथ जब बहुत एक सिंपल गाना मुझे लगा कि अच्छा बहुत सिंपल ट्यून है, बट माइक पे जाके यू फील दैट ओह नो इट इज नॉट सो सिंपल टू सिंग अ सिंपल सॉन्ग.
ऑफ कोर्स, इज देयर एनी सॉन्ग व्हिच यू डिड नॉट सिंग बट यू विश्ड कि ये गाना मुझे गाना चाहिए या ये गाना मुझे गाना है?
ऐसे कोई गाने ज्यादा तो है नहीं. ऐसे मेल सॉन्ग्स हैं बहुत जो मैं सुनती हूँ कि इसका एक फीमेल वर्जन होना चाहिए था. इनफैक्ट मैं काफ़ी बार बोलती हूँ भी, जो मेरे कंपोजर्स, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर माय फ्रेंड्स, दैट आफ्टर दैट सॉन्ग रिलीजेज एंड आई से डूड व्हाई डिडंट यू डू अ वन फीमेल वर्जन, यू शुड हैव जस्ट डन इट, वेदर इट वाज नॉट इन द फिल्म और नॉट, यू शुड हैव जस्ट, आई विल सिंग वन यू नो वर्जन फॉर यू. ऐसे कुछ गाने हैं जो मुझे बहुत पसंद है, जैसे सोनू जी का गाना है अभी मुझ में कहीं, या अरिजीत का एक गाना है, जीत दा का म्यूजिक है अभी मुझ में कहीं, अजय अतुल का गाना है, और जीत गांगुली का एक गाना है, मैं उनको हमेशा बोलती हूँ हमारी अधूरी कहानी, मुझे बहुत पसंद है वो गाना. या इवन मुस्कुराने की वजह तुम हो, सम सॉन्ग्स लाइक दैट आई फील दैट वी कुड हैव हैड अ फीमेल वर्जन ऑफ दैट. नो आई थिंक दोज लेट इट बी अ सरप्राइज, वन डे आई सिंग वन ऑफ दोज सॉन्ग्स. मेरे पास लिरिक्स नहीं है गानों के, नहीं तो गा देती.
आजकल जो म्यूजिक रिक्रिएट हो रहा है, पुराना म्यूजिक रिक्रिएट हो रहा है, उसके बारे में व्हाट डू यू थिंक? डोंट यू थिंक कि जो ओरिजिनलिटी है वो चली जाती है कहीं ना कहीं?
हाँ होती है, आई मीन वो थोड़ा रिस्पेक्ट और प्यार से अगर करे तो उसको बरकरार रखते हुए हम कर सकते हैं कुछ इंटरेस्टिंग काम, पर बहुत वक्त होता है कि वो ओरिजिनलिटी तो दूर हो जाती है, साथ में साथ उसकी जो सोल है वो भी गायब नहीं, वो बहुत चेंज हो जाता है हर गाने के एक, व्हेन द क्रिएटर मेड दैट सॉन्ग, द क्रिएटर ऑफ दैट सॉन्ग, कंपोजर, लिरिसिस्ट, वो जब बैठे सिंगर के साथ, उन्होंने एक आइडिया सोचा, उसको एक तरह से एग्जीक्यूट किया, उसका मैजिक उसी चीज़ से बना है कि वो जो कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थॉट्स एंड द थिंग्स पुट टुगेदर मेड इट व्हाट दैट सॉन्ग वाज. टेक अवे दैट मैजिकल एलिमेंट ऑफ इट एंड इट बिकम्स जस्ट अनदर सॉन्ग. सो आई फील दैट व्हेनेवर वी डू द रिक्रिएशंस वी शुड जस्ट ऑनर दैट सेंटिमेंट ऑफ व्हाई दैट सॉन्ग वाज सो बिग. एंड in the recent times I've done one song and I actually requested that let me do that version which I honestly like, which was there in the film. And they kept my request, and in fact I didn't have to request much. I just sang the original way the song was, and instantly everyone said, let's do this. So it's the power of the rendition of these songs that has to be done that way, otherwise wo gaane ka wo nahi magic aayega.
Okay, with that we come to the end of the session, but how is this possible ki we have Shreya Ghoshal with us and she's not made to sing? She will have to sing some song for us. One song, any song.
Did I sing Dhadkane Azaad Hain too? Let me sing. We're talking about the single. Maine gana hi nahi gaya. Kaise ho sakta hai? Ye gana aap sunna aur jaake video bhi dekhna YouTube pe. Mera channel of kya hai? Shreya Ghoshal official. Okay. Let me sing it for you. चाहे जितनी दूर हो, चाहे जितना हो खफा, लौट कर आ जाएंगे, तुम बुला कर देख लो, प्यार छुपता ही नहीं, तुम छुपा कर देख लो, धड़कने आजाद है, पहरे लगा कर देख लो.
Wow, it gave me goosebumps. Thank you so much for your time. It was lovely speaking to you. Thank you.